Alrighty then. Hey guys, what's up? It's me, Priscilla. And as you can see, I'm writing down all the princesses' names in one list and in a bunch of random cute animals in another list. So I thought it would be fun if I went ahead and I did this challenge. I remember last year about this time of the year, I did this challenge where I turned the Sing characters from Illumination's movie Sing with the koala bear and all that fun stuff where the animals sing, and I turned those into people as opposed to humans. So I thought it'd be fun to turn the princesses, the Disney princesses, into these random animals. And as you can see, I did not cheat. I closed my eyes, I felt around, and I picked my papers. Just gotta trust me on it because I'm not gonna record my face while I'm doing this. So I went ahead and I got Tiana as a sloth first. And I wanted to make Tiana a three-toed sloth because a three-toed sloth is so much better and so much cuter and so much nicer than a two-toed sloth. So of course, with the sloth being Tiana, I wanted to incorporate her dress, of course, and her last dress. It's just funny. Tiana can't catch a break. She keeps turning into animals. I should have wrote frog onto one of the animals on my list, but it would have been just my luck if I would have drawn Tiana and frog from my hats, but no. This isn't the first time I've drawn a sloth before. I think for National Donut Day, I drew a sloth hugging a donut, and I still did a three-toed sloth because I think they're cuter and sweeter. Because I heard that two-toed sloths are super aggressive. So, and I think that this is the actual sloth that everybody's obsessed with now more than the two-toed sloth. I mean, two-toed sloths are cute when they're babies, but technically it's cute when they're all grown-ups and they're trying to claw your throat out, as I have read somewhere. I don't know. If somebody has a two-toed sloth as a pet, please leave in the comments down below. I'm coming over and I'm going to pet the sloth and hopefully he won't eat my face. But anyway, so this is just a lot of fun to create Tiana as this little sloth. I went ahead and I drew a couple of little fireflies around her because it just would make sense to put a little bit of fireflies all around her because, you know, Ray and all the fireflies and going down the bayou. Going down the bayou. Alright, and so I picked two more out of my cats, and it turned out to be Snow White as an alpaca. Now, I've never really been a fan of Snow White, so I wanted to draw one of the princesses as an alpaca, but when it came to Snow White, I went, I don't really want to draw her, but whatever, gotta go with what I picked from my hats. So I drew a basic alpaca, and I love drawing alpacas. I think they're just the cutest things in the world to draw. I think it would be super cute to put a big, fat, fluffy alpaca in Snow White's dress. So I went ahead and I drew out the basic dress for Snow White, and I was looking at different pictures of an alpaca, and some of them, if you realize, some of them do have a lot of markings similar to llamas, where they have spots on them, or they have just different areas that are different colors. So I saw an alpaca, and the only part that was a dark brown blackish thing was on top of his neck behind his fur that's already on his face going up. It's all kinds of layers of the alpaca fur because they're just so fluffy and cute. But I went ahead and I made her tail black and I made the top of her head black just to kind of signify that she had those markings, but I didn't just want to leave the top of her head black. I wanted to incorporate somewhere else on her body, but I didn't want to give her spots either. So this one was a little bit difficult just to try to figure out where am I going to put the designs on this alpaca to make this look like snow. And I went ahead and I added more little fluffy spots all over, but I really like the way that I did her ears and her the top of her head in the black fashion sense. All right, here comes another. I do five of these guys. I do five princesses as animals. And this one was a little bit interesting because I wrote down two different fishies on my list, and I wrote down betta fish and tropical fish. So betta fish, Anna as a betta fish. Well, betta fish, well, the really pretty ones for one are male, I guess, and I didn't figure that out because I had been naming all my betta fish these girly girl names all my life for the betta fish, the really colorful ones that you get from PetSmart, and I didn't realize they're boys. So I had all these boys and I was totally giving them girl names because I thought they're pretty. So I thought, okay, well, obviously we're gonna have a miraculous event and turn this betta fish, a really pretty betta fish, into a girl because it has to be Anna. So, all right. Betta fish are really pretty, but I wanted to... Their colors are outrageous, so it kind of worked with Anna because she has orange hair, so I wanted to make her body orange, and then I wanted to go with her, you know, her mountain climbing search for Elsa adventure outfit where she had her pink cape and her blue skirt and then her black top, and I wanted to incorporate that into the betta fish, so it was super easy and a lot of fun to make an actual betta fish into a princess. Now, this one I had a little bit more trouble with because an elephant. Cinderella as an elephant? Okay, so what I had problems with is I didn't want it to look like Mina from the movie Sing, as I previously mentioned at the beginning of this video. I didn't want her to look like Mina. I had to make this in my own style, and I didn't want her to look like the mom from Dumbo. I had to do this, and it was really, really tough on drawing her as an elephant, and the coloring was super tough too because I wanted her to be gray, but then I wanted her to be blue, and nothing was working, and I used a too dark of a C. I used C7 on her to kind of do some shadows and shading on her, and it just wasn't working. This was by far the toughest animal in this entire video that was really hard on transforming into a princess, and I really hate the fact that I used the open ears with her. I really wanted, I looked at that and I went, no, I shouldn't have done that as soon as I was done with it. How is it that always happens with us artists? We start to do something and then we go, well, I shouldn't have done that. That was a horrible artistic choice. And see, there she just looks like she has angry eyebrows right now. So this was my least favorite animal out of this whole challenge. But I really wish I would have not put the pink on, but put just, you know, pure gray right across her ears, and then put like a tinge of yellow on top of them to signify her blonde hair. But nope, this just wasn't gonna work. And then you see I keep going over and over that angry eyebrow, and she just kept looking angry to me, and I just went, I don't like this elephant. I mean, I really wanted to draw Cinderella as an animal, but I really just don't like the fact that she's an elephant. But it would have been really cute to have a Cinder Ellie. Get it? Cinder Ellie elephant. I know, I'm here all week, guys. Go on. Just walk out now. Just tip me on the way out. No. And then the last one that I picked from my two hats were Belle as a cat. Now, I put Tiger on there too, and I was really hoping I would have gotten Tiger for one of the princesses, just if it wasn't Jasmine. Hopefully not. But I went ahead and I drew Belle as a typical house cat. Now, I was going for a calico cat because they have a lot of browns all over them. I think that's right. I've never owned a cat in my life, so I don't really know all the actual breeds of cats, but I think the calico cat is the one I was going for when it came to Belle. Now, I looked at some standard Disney cats, and I tried to get those eyes, that typical fashion of eyes when it comes to cats, the boxes around their eyes. Disney does that a lot for their Disney cats and Disney dogs. They have it just these areas around their eyes, which just signifies just like their eye sockets in a way. I don't know, but it just, I really love how the way that they do that. So I was looking at different Disney cats. I was looking at pictures of Duchess and Marie and Oliver from Oliver and Company, and I was trying to get that look of that Disney cat because I was like, this is Belle. This is everyone's favorite princess. I've got to make it the most cutest cat ever. So I have to say that I think that Belle as a house cat was my favorite out of all the princesses that I had made out of these five. I just think it's super cute that I wanted her on top of a book. I should have done something more. I should have had like one of the enchanted characters next to her, or like Little Lumiere. I need to add that and put it on my Instagram or something. Just Little Lumiere looking over her shoulder. But yes, guys, these are my princess animers. I don't know. But these are my Disney princesses as animals. It was a fun challenge, and I thought this would be really cool to do because I was reminded of that Sing video, and I thought, you know, I should do the Disney princesses as animals, but which animals would they be? So I loved the whole game that I gave myself to go and pick one from one hat from the princesses and pick an animal from the other hat. But yes, what was your favorite animal? You guys should try to do this challenge with me. Would you be interested in seeing another video like this? Leave in the comments down below. I'd love to know if you want me to keep going and try to get all the princesses done as these animals. I'd love to know your opinions. I hope you all have a most wonderful weekend, and I will see you all later. Bye!